Hi, I'm Dr. Sangeeta Honnur, founder of Smile Elements Dental, Belandur, Bangalore. Failing root canal can usually be diagnosed by either subjective or objective clinical symptoms, clinical investigations, and radiographs. So usually we do see patients come in complaining of pain with the treated root canal, which was probably done earlier. So we do check the history of the root canal and do a certain clinical tests where we do check if there is a pocket depth that's increasing, and there is a percussion test where we tap the tooth and check, and followed by x-rays. So usually when you see an x-ray is what gives you an idea of probably how the root canal was done. I mean, mainly what we see in the x-ray is actually the filling, the obturation. That's the only thing what you can say if it's done well or not done well. So in spite of sometimes when we see the root canal is done well, we do see failures that happen, which could be because of other reasons that have happened during the cleaning, shaping, irrigation process of the tooth. And in spite of all that that is followed well, it could be because of the crown that was placed after the root canal was done. Because a lot of studies have been done that show that endodontic therapy is very much dependent on how the prosthetic process has gone after that. If there's no good integrity between the crown and the root canal tooth, failure of the root canal is much higher. So that's the call. That's how you get to know how the root canal has failed. And basically that's where you take it forward to see if that tooth, prognosis for that tooth is good, if a re-RCT can be initiated or a better crown that has to be put, or along with the re-RCT and the crown, does it need any apicosectomy that has to be done to save the tooth can be planned.